Hello and welcome to God's View. We're so glad you joined us today. I have a powerful subject. Help! I'm in the wilderness. And so God's got some help for all of us today. He's got some great things through the Holy Spirit, through us, to speak that will encourage you and both us. So remember, while we're going through the program, to call the prayer lines, 307-637-PRAY. It's periodically across the bottom of the screen and always right here behind my head. And we make sure that we give you those prayer lines over and over and over, because our heart is not to see anybody go through things alone.
Amen.
It's so difficult as it is, mm-hmm. when you have brothers and sisters, mm-hmm. and prayer partners. When Satan hits you with something, you need prayer and agreement with heaven in that moment and in that season so that you can get through it.
Amen.
You know, going through means in one side and out the other. Yeah, you're going through, you really are going through, mm-hmm. some stuff, but you're going in one side and you're going to come out the other, because God is with you.
Amen.
He'll never leave you,
mm-hmm.
and forsake you. So help, I'm in the wilderness, been there many times. And so God's going to give us some help today.
Mm-hmm.
With that said, many of you that click through the channel, we hear on the prayer lines, and it's your first time viewer. Well, welcome if you're a first time viewer. Stay parked right there, because we got a great, great show today that I know that will bless you, help you, and encourage you. I'm Charlene Back to Mary, one of your God's View hosts, and I love doing these shows. And this is Sean Pruitt, and he's going to be with us for the next 4 weeks, and he was with us for 6 weeks, so you've been with us for about 10 weeks now. So
seems like just a day.
Seems like just that's pretty funny. It's the inside joke. That's pretty funny. But anyways, he's an anointed man of God. He's an anointed man of God. He has a ministry, and he's very prophetic. Him and his
Amen.
Wife both. And they're actually ordained under our ministry. They're
Amen.
Ordained fivefold ministers of the gospel of Jesus
she
Christ.
She sounds amazing.
And and this is his wife, Priscilla, our other co-host. And she is, of course, if any of you, all of you know that normally watch, that she is our regular host. And but for you that just tuned in, you don't know these things. So
mm-hmm.
she's with, he's here doing 9 weeks with us, as we have lost a co-host. Mm-hmm. I never say that,
mm-hmm.
but for great reason. She moved to do great things
great
for God
things.
In California. And so, they come and they go. That's God's, thing,
yeah.
And so he's bringing us somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
He
mm-hmm.
will, and it's going to be dynamic, and you're going to love him just mm-hmm. as much as we do. And this, last but not least, is Lana Gardner.
Hello.
And we welcome you to the show. We are excited to go. And you know, Priscilla, you said you had a lot on the subject.
I do.
So why
this
don't
is
you
such
just
a
roll
good
with
subject.
It? Yeah, why don't you just go with it?
It's funny, because we just came out of the wilderness, so I got a lot of expertise in this area. But you know, one of the things that I thought was really cool, and I'm going to skip forward to this because this was the neatest thing, you know, Elijah was in the wilderness. He traveled into the wilderness for 40 days
mm-hmm.
to commune with God.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days. And the Israelites were in the wilderness for 40 years. And so most Bible scholars believe that the number 40 is highly symbolic and refers to a significant, purposeful, spiritual time in a person or nation's life.
Amen.
And you know what's funny
what
is
I
that
say.
It's so true, though. Last year, Sean turned 40. And last year was our 40th year, his 40th year, not me, I'm much younger. I am younger, so don't laugh at that one.
Yeah.
But he was 40, and I told him, I was like, you know, honey, it's weird that we were in the wilderness all last year, and you were 40.
Mm.
And, Jesus was 40 days, the Israelites were 40 years, and Elijah was 40 days. So I'm like, there's something to that. Isn't that cool?
Mm, yes.
So I thought, you know, that's really neat. So going off in rabbit trails, but you know the word Midbar? Araba and Eremos are all words that translate into the word wilderness in the Word of God.
Mm.
And those words are 300 times. They're in the Bible 300 times. So that means it's something that's important, right?
Right.
If you see
it's
something in the Bible
God.
300 times,
it's
pay attention.
Important.
Uh-huh. It's important. So no believer, no one can escape the wilderness. At some
that's
point
right.
in your life, every one of us will walk through the wilderness, and it's not something bad. I love that you opened by saying that, because it's not something bad. The wilderness is actually, it's a place where God hides you from the public. in order to prepare you for His purpose.
That's right.
Yes.
Isn't that beautiful?
It's beautiful. I always say He's not taking something from you. Mm-mm. He's getting something Amen. To you. He's working things out. And most of the time it's in us.
It yeah. is. And mm-hmm. that's where God introduces Himself to us in a more deeper and intimate
yes.
way. And it says in Jeremiah 29:13, "You will find me when I search you, when you search me for me with all your heart." And so God tells us when we search for Him with all of our hearts, when we get into that wilderness area, we're desperate. And that's when we fully search for Him
yes.
with all of our hearts. And God says, and He promises us, "You will find me when mm-hmm. you search for me with
yes.
all of your heart."
All of your heart.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
And then
Amen.
In Psalms 42 it says, "When he was thirsty for God in the wilderness, my soul pants for thee, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. Why are you in despair, O my soul? Why have you forgotten me, O God?" And see, David goes on to encourage us with these words by, you know, he's saying, "Thou hast taken account of my wanderings and put my tears in a bottle." And so even David, who was considered the man after God's own heart, he even felt like despair. He felt like he was in the wilderness. He was in the wilderness for years, for a long
yes,
time.
Sure. Yes.
When Saul was trying to kill him, mm-hmm. was trying to, you know, seriously take his life because he was so jealous. Mm-hmm. And so everybody had to go through. Jesus had to go through. Matthew, Mark, Luke, all of them speak about Jesus' wilderness experience. And they all tell us that the Spirit drove Jesus. The Spirit drove mm-hmm. Jesus mm-hmm. into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
The Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
The verb that they use as drove in the Greek means compulsion, violently. So the Spirit violently mm. hounded Jesus
yeah.
to go to the wilderness.
Wow.
So there
yeah.
is a purpose for the wilderness.
Yes. Mm. And you know, Joseph, if you look at it, Joseph was in the wilderness. He was in the wilderness
oh, yeah.
for years.
Yeah.
You know, people can call it what they want, but my God, he was betrayed. And then mm-hmm. Potiphar's wife,
right.
you know, makes up all those lies. His brothers throw him in the pit and
yeah.
wait, you know, want him
falsely
dead.
Falsely accused.
Falsely yeah. accused. I mean, mm. you know, then the baker that was supposed to go, you know, and get him out, help
forgot
him.
All
yeah,
about
forgot all about
left
him.
Left him in prison.
And you know, he went through so much. That's called
yeah.
wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
But what happened to Joseph? He's such yeah. a prime picture of Jesus
yes.
in the Bible.
Yes.
And then forgiving his brothers and weeping over them. And then God bringing his whole family and
mm-hmm.
all
yes.
the restoration. That's what happens when you come out of the wilderness. So if you're there, things got to switch for you.
Amen.
Let your perspective switch, because you may have been going through hell for years.
Yeah.
Through everything. And you think, what did I do wrong? Nothing. You know what? You're going to come out. You're going to come out. Wow. Really great. You know, a lot of you, when we call this help, I'm in the wilderness. Many of you feel like you're just standing still if it's been ministry and you see all these other ministries flourishing and you want to flourish.
That's true.
And then it seems like many around you are just moving forward, whether it's with finances or their job or their kids are doing great and your kids are all messed up, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you think of these things mm-hmm. and the devil starts beating you up and thinking, you know, but you know, these are wilderness places, but your kids too, this will pass.
Mm-hmm.
And if they don't, God still has them. You got to do what you got to do and just pray. You got to let go sometimes. Finance is crazy. You seem stagnant. You think like, you know, there's things in your body that has been going on for years and you're thinking, what is going on? Or
mm-hmm.
I'm sick all the time or this or that. Listen, I'll tell you what, you're coming out of this wilderness
mm-hmm.
and you'll come out with power and you'll come out strong.
Yeah, Amen. Well, you know, the wilderness is actually a part of the promised land.
Amen.
Yes.
You see, you have to
mm-hmm.
go through the wilderness
Amen.
In order to get to
exactly.
the promised land.
Yes.
And
yes.
what is
yes.
the
yes.
wilderness?
Uh-huh.
Hardships
mm-hmm. That's good.
And losses and challenges and tears
mm-hmm.
and so
yes.
forth and so on. But really, the wilderness is almost half of our lives.
It is.
Oh gosh, I
it
know.
It really is. And what is God doing?
What a
great He's taking
you
us.
No,
yeah.
no, great word.
It's
no.
true.
But it's true.
It's a place you
it's
don't
want
to be. But
uh-huh.
but it's leading you to where you do want to be.
Exactly.
Yes.
And so you'll get there faster to where you do want to be if you keep your eyes on Jesus,
Amen.
Uh-huh.
if you stay in the Word, if you
yeah.
pray, if you thank Him, even in the midst of wilderness, if you're in God, He makes it good.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So,
Amen. You know, and I'm going to add to that, the wilderness is where your greatest faith grows.
Yes.
When the Israelites were in the wilderness, that's when the Jordan parted.
Mm-hmm.
In the wilderness,
yes.
that's where they were fed manna.
Woo-hoo!
In the wilderness, that's
yeah,
where
glory.
The rock watered 3 million people. Mm-hmm. Our greatest faith grows in the wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the last stop. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Amen. It's the last stop before the promised land. Yeah. We didn't start in the wilderness.
No.
We started in the Garden of Eden. Yes. We screwed up.
Yeah.
In Genesis 3, it says, he said to the woman, this is the serpent, Satan said to the woman, did God actually say, you shall not eat of any tree in the garden? See, he went to the woman and caused her to question her father, what he actually said. There's so many of us don't believe the word of God. Mm-hmm. Does God really want me to prosper? Does he really want me to have a beautiful family?
Does he really want me to be healed? Good.
This mm-hmm. cancer is his will. Just leave me alone. That is a lie
or
from
ministry,
the devil.
Or ministry, they say. Does God
but
really
you,
want
your faith mm-hmm. determines the length of your stay. When the Israelites left the house of bondage and they went to the wilderness, it took 11 mm. days from Egypt to the promised land. But the giants... because of the fear of the mm-hmm. giants, they decided to wander in the desert for
yeah.
40 years.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Don't let Satan determine your length of stay. Use the word of God.
Ooh, that's
and fight.
Good. Uh-huh. Say it again. Don't,
yeah. don't let Satan determine the length of your stay. You need to just be like
yeah.
David. Pick
mm-hmm.
up those mm-hmm. rocks and sling
come
that
on.
To
right.
the giant uh-huh. and slay him and become the king
come
that
on.
Jesus has died
and
for.
And you know, that's such a good point because the Israelites could have gotten to the, they could have been in the promised land
in
11
days.
Days.
Yeah. 11,
yeah. 11 days. But instead, because they had not listened right. to the Spirit of God, to yep. the prompting that God said, that's your land, take it.
Mm-hmm.
No,
mm-hmm.
they let fear come in.
That's
like,
right.
It's like he said, you do not, Satan does not determine the length of your stay.
That's right.
Amen.
We
yes,
determine it.
It does
and so
not
instead,
determine.
They wandered around for
glory,
40
glory.
Years.
Amen.
And never made it into
and
the promised
yeah,
land.
Never
there
made
were
it.
Only
never
two,
made it. I know.
Two people
Joseph.
That made
Amen.
It in the promised
Joshua
land.
Joshua and Caleb.
Joshua and Caleb. And yep. only. And mm-hmm. only because... they had
yeah.
faith.
So sad.
They
Amen.
Stood on the word. They believed.
Yeah.
Don't you remember?
Amen.
They would talk to the Israeli children. They say, don't you remember all God
don't
has done?
Remember, yes.
Don't you
yeah.
remember all of his promises?
They never
Amazing.
Went hungry. Fresh manna from heaven every
yeah.
morning.
Clothes
and then they
never
started
wore
complaining
up.
About that. You know,
yeah.
they wanted chicken and they wanted hamburgers.
Manna
they wanted
burgers.
Double cheeseburgers.
They wanted Chick-fil-A.
They wanted, yeah, they wanted
You
want a big old filet mignon,
yeah.
baked potato.
Sarah is another one that God had made a promise to her that she was going to conceive because especially
yeah.
in those days, mm-hmm. if a woman didn't have a child, it was a humiliation and alone all the other emotional
factors. They thought they were unblessed if they were barren.
And
they
God
didn't
said,
yeah. they
Sarah,
were blessed.
I'm going to give
You're
you a
cursed.
Son. Sarah went, yes. And she's waiting, and
mm-hmm.
she's waiting, and she's 90 years old.
Yeah.
And
Amen.
And she's still waiting for the promise. But she waited, and it came.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know,
and God is faithful.
You know, it just hit me as we're sitting here. You know, Satan came to Eve and said, did God really say? He got him to be separated from the Father and started questioning the very words from the Father. But Jesus said, when Satan came to Jesus, he said, if you are the Son of God, Satan said this, command these stones to become loaves of bread. This is while he's in the wilderness. But he answered, Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from mm-hmm. the mouth of God. Jesus had a direct communion with God, and he believed his word, and he was living from the voice of God and not from the voice of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
And what got me out of that wilderness, I finally said, you know what? I tried religion. I tried mm-hmm. church. I tried doing this. I tried doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And I just started trusting and believing that small, still voice from my relationship. By seeking Jesus
mm-hmm.
and believing what he says versus what the world is
mm-hmm.
saying.
Because
I don't care
glory.
Who's in your life. I don't care who is in your life. They will always speak things from the enemy without, they don't purposely do
they
it.
They don't purposely do it,
But not all of us are speaking faith all the time. I speak lies sometimes. Sometimes I say things that hurt my wife. Jesus told her to do something. I'm like, hey, are you sure God told you to do that?
Twice.
Are you sure you should become Mrs. Wyoming?
Who's keeping record?
I mean, you only have 30 days. She only had 30 days to prepare for Mrs. Wyoming. I'm like, are you sure?
Yeah, are you sure?
Are you sure you should do that?
And you won. That's so good. But you know what you're saying, you know, the thing is when we're in the wilderness, We have to shut that voice off and know that God has the purpose. He has the plan that he predestined and ordained. And in that purpose, all you do is in that wilderness, as you keep decreeing and declaring the word of God. That's what Jesus did. He kept telling the devil, it's written. He didn't get all exhausted. He didn't do all these things. He just kept saying it's written. Because you do not have to perform the word. The word is what and will accomplish. The word will accomplish what God sent it forth to do. He said, just as the snow falls to the ground and soaks it and cannot return to me void, so is it that my word goes forth over your life and will accomplish that which I sent it forth to do. So the word is what's accomplishing. So in that wilderness season, what the devil tempts you to do is, just like Sean said, question, did God really say, because look at this, has been a long time. Did God really say that my son's going to do this or come out of this, or my daughter or whatever? He gets you to question. But what you got to do is know that the word is always performing on your behalf if you decree it and believe it and keep building that way. It goes forth and accomplishes. You know, God told me years ago, and this is something that you've got to, because especially right now in this last day, in this hour, a lot of people are following man's ways. And I'm telling you, there's some good pastors out there that have went sideways and man has followed them because they say, oh no, my pastor's great and he's good. And you know, hey, there are some good ones. I'm not saying, you know, hey, I love pastors. I got good friends. But I'm just saying there's a major guy right now saying that no longer is the Ten Commandments valid for the New Testament church. Now, we know that's off the hook. You know, the Old Testament and the New Testament go together, flow together from Genesis to maps, and we are not to get rid of any of it. Well, the thing is, years ago, what will happen is, it's a fine line, and this is what God spoke to me. My people are believing so much in what they have been taught and what they are doing, they are expecting it to make the change. And that's a very serious thing. And you have to get that revelated to you, because what happens is, like, let's just give a little example. We all been doing prayer group forever, and all of a sudden somebody starts getting a bunch of miracles. You know, all this stuff starts happening. And before you know it, what's the first thing that people say? Oh, yeah, we prayed that. Yeah, we did that. We did that. It's a fine line, because what you do, you're believing so much in what you're doing. Yeah. You're expecting it to make the change. And I have seen this deception go like wildfire for years through the body of Christ in many different aspects. And so what you want to do is make sure you ask God on everything in your wilderness. Just ask him. It's not like you're sitting at the feet of whys and ifs and how comes. Well, some of you do, because you get so, it's been so long and you're so desperate. You're saying, why, God, am I going through this? The devil wants you to start blaming yourself. Why have I been this bad that I deserve this? No, that's not it. It's just that your wilderness is lasting a little longer. I don't know why. I'm not God, but I know he doesn't want you to be there forever. He's a good God and he's got blessings for you. But in that, you want to make sure that you always surrender to God and not to man, because too many people follow that. And then if they go off, they just go off too. Yeah. You've got to know it's God. And like he said, not believe so much in what you're doing, or believe so much what that man said, and then you don't ask God, because God may tell you to do something totally different. I mean, he told me years ago to do something different and leave the church, and I had to go build this ministry. I mean, I had people come against me, and I usually don't talk about this because I love them. I adore them. I'm not mad at anybody. Nothing of that nature. Please hear me. It's just that because of a belief system and what people had been taught, I was called rebellious, not submitted or committed, and I didn't hear from God. But of course, all that's turned around now that God has done everything that he said, and we had to leave for a reason. We didn't leave because we thought anybody was bad. But what if? What if? Okay, let's just look at that. If I would have listened to them, if I would have listened to man and they said, no, no, this is not God, you're not supposed to do this, and I stayed building that ministry, God's view wouldn't be here.
Amen.
It wouldn't be here. I'm telling you, it wouldn't be here. Because I would have followed man and what they told me to do. And that's why it's so very important when you're in the wilderness, you listen to God. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have to Amen. Go against every normal voice, like you were saying Amen. Earlier. You have to go against every single voice that is saying something that they believe they're doing good because of a belief system that they've been taught. They really believe they're telling you the truth. It's not that they're bad people. It's not that they want to destroy you. They believe it with all their heart. But you got to believe the Father even greater. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And you can't start questioning, like he said, in this way, was my pastor right? Mm-hmm. Is the leadership Amen. Right? Did I not hear from you, God?
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Because I guarantee the devil will do it to you. But I had to stand and say, God, you said to build this great network. You said to build this studio. You said there'll be a show called mm-hmm. God's View that mm-hmm. will go around the yeah. world and be known for mm-hmm. your glory. And guess what? Here I sit because I didn't listen to the voice that said, are you sure yep. you're not right, Charlene? Because believe me, I went to bed many nights just torn. Well, maybe they are right. Maybe I am rebellious. Maybe mm-hmm. I didn't hear from God. Yeah. Just like Adam yep. and Eve.
Amen. Yeah. And see, you were tempted to desperation.
Yes.
And that's what Satan does. He tempts us to where we're desperate for an answer, to where yes. we just turn to anything.
Amen.
We'll make rash decisions yep. because we don't have that patience.
That's good. Yeah.
You know, we're tempted to give up on God. And that's what uh-huh. Satan's really good at. And even Jesus, he even put Jesus in that area, in that place, to where he was tempted to give up on God, because he was violently thrown into this area where he was hounded for 40 days. It wasn't one day that Satan came. He hounded him for 40 days.
Yes.
And it was in this wilderness that was barren. It was dry. It was a place where no life grows, where nothing was thriving. Yeah.
Amen.
I mean, he hadn't
Preach
eaten.
It, girl.
He hadn't drinking
Look at
water.
Her. She was like flowing.
I know. I feel
She's I'd like going, that's good. That's good.
But
you
it's
want
true.
That?
That's where we have to be sometimes.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Jesus himself had to be there where he had nothing
amen.
To turn to.
Amen.
I mean, we have to fight. How did Jesus fight? He fought with the sword. I'm not talking about the sword, like an actual sword. Yeah. He fought with the sword, the word of God. And that's what we have to do.
It will not return
void. It will never return. We have to be persuaded that God is able mm-hmm. and that we can receive that power
Amen.
And that we get to the promised mm-hmm. land. And the way we get it is to work our faith.
Amen.
Faith in what? Faith in his word.
Yes.
And, you know, everyone is dealt a measure of faith. So don't say that you don't have enough faith. Mm-hmm. You've got as much faith as anybody in the
Amen.
Body. That's right. It's a matter of using that
came,
faith. Are you willing to use the faith that you have, that measure?
Yes.
And if you do, you got it.
Amen.
God is
you
know, with you.
I just really feel in my heart, there's somebody out there that thinks they've done something so bad. They're in the wilderness right now. You may be in prison. I feel that there's people watching that are in prison, and mm-hmm. I feel like there's just people out there, a man that cheated on his wife, they just feel like they deserve their prison. They deserve their wilderness.
No.
Well, guess what? We all deserve
Amen.
Eternal damnation. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It says in the Word that we all yep. come short of the glory of God, but it also says Galatians 3:13, Jesus redeemed us from the curse of the
Amen.
Law.
Amen.
So you might be in this wilderness for a time, but once you realize that mm-hmm. Jesus died for every mm-hmm. sin, and all you have to do, it's really easy.
Repent.
Jesus, I repent.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Take me back.
Yes.
He'll take you back like that. He'll
That's
give
right.
you the strategy to get from the wilderness to mm-hmm. the promised land.
And
you
can
have new
speak
wine.
To that wilderness too.
Yeah. New wine.
Yes.
New wine. A new wineskin is only a repentive
Amen.
Heart.
Yes.
You can't hold it if you're in your position.
Yes.
And again, in this place, don't try to perform something. Mm-hmm. Don't try to make something happen. The word will accomplish if you just decree and declare, like I said. Jesus did it all on the cross.
Amen.
What I was talking about a few minutes ago, the word accomplishes for you and it will
Amen.
Not return void.
Yeah.
And
yes.
that's what Jesus used in his wilderness season. And if you've been in there forever, it doesn't matter. But don't nullify the word. You know, I looked up nullify, and when we go into this place to where we're just trying to perform and we're just in this miserable place of questioning, we nullify the word of God. And nullify is make legally null and void and invalidate. You know, it's you got to declare. You've got to keep decreeing. You've got to keep believing. I can't say that enough to people, because in the times where I had so many issues crashing at my ship, I tell you, I would look out my windows literally and say, God, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but I trust in the name of the Lord my God, and I know you're going to do it. I know you'll bring me through. I know what this looks like. Some of my most torn moments when you have somebody, things in life come against you, come against your ministry, flat out lies. I've went through so many things, but so did Joseph, so did Jesus, so did Paul. They even said, Paul, oh, is that one who led all of these terrorists out into the desert? And, you know, he was called so many things. All of us are. And in those times, does it hurt? Yes, because we want everybody to like us, which I was saying this earlier. No, everybody doesn't like you, and they're not going to. And that's okay. Yep. You bless those who persecute you. Amen. But, you know, it doesn't make it any easier. Yeah. It doesn't make it any easier when all these people come against you or your ministry. Amen. But you know what? You know when that stuff starts happening, there's a promotion coming. Yes. I've seen this pattern over and over and over. And every time somebody has come against this ministry with lies, I mean, there's been so many things said about me for years. But you know what? I just let it go for it because, you know what? Amen. Then all of a sudden I'll go on 250 more million homes. Or you know what I mean? I'd say, go for it. You just go for it because you're promoting me. Thank you very much.
I am so past that. I mean, really, I just care about pleasing the Lord, period.
Amen.
And I don't care what people think, what anything. I just care about pleasing Him.
Amen.
And
it works. That's true.
Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. It's time to go. I mean, I don't mean it's hallelujah because good, it's time to go. I mean, hallelujah, it's good to bring people to the Lord.
Right.
It's our, time flies when you're having a good time, I'll guarantee you. And we have a good time up here in the Lord. We love Him with all of our hearts. And the glory of God rest in this studio.
Amen.
And let it come through that camera right now. Let His presence come and flood over you. Those who are lost, let you come on your knees and just cry out to the living God, create in me a pure heart, renew a right spirit within me right now. God wants you. He wants all your broken life, all the broken pieces. He wants to put you back together again. Just like that old saying, Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall, Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses, all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty together again, but Jesus can put you together again. Man can't do nothing, but you may have had a big fall, but Jesus will put you back together. All you got to do, anybody who calls on His name, He says, all who call on my name will be saved. And all you got to do is confess with your mouth, believe in your heart, merge those two, you're saved. Believe, tell Him, forgive me of my sin, God. I need you. I need what they have up here. I've listened to them and I need this. And if you've said that prayer and asked Jesus into your heart, I'll tell you, He died on a cross. He rose again and He's coming back to get you. You don't want to spend eternity in hell. There's two places, hell and heaven. And hell is nothing. It has so much darkness. You won't have hope, nothing. And it's eternal. So I hope you said that prayer today. And if you did, call our prayer lines 307-637-PRAY. Go to our website, please. Hit the donate button today. We need some consistent givers to keep coming into your home and going around the world for the gospel of Jesus Christ. You know, people think $5 a month is too cheap. Hey, you get a few people giving $5 a month, $10 a month, it adds up.
Consistent.
And yes, consistent. We've been on almost 11 years and we need consistent donors. We love you. It's only goodbye for today. Jesus loves you more. See you soon.